So good morning, everybody, and we welcome you guys secondary school. And we have here our chief guest,
check
Dr. Hello. Franklin Daniel. We are very glad to have him here. He's the associate professor, a man of wisdom, has a huge profile, and we are happy to have you here, sir. Thank you so much. And we have a respected correspondent, Mr. Tyagarajan Marcus, and our administrator, Mrs. Diana Peter, and our principal, Mrs. Kernaff.
Thank you for the beautiful morning session of your presence with our children, young ones, and small kids, O Father. May you lead every one of them into a good way of talking and behaving, all for your glory. Thank you for our chief guest this morning from MCC. And help us and guide us throughout our lifetime to glorify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to culturals.
Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that.
Let's hand over the mic to Sanjeev, sir, for the welcome note.
To welcome the gathering, on behalf of the Department of English, Ebenezer Marcus Matrix High Secondary School. First, I cordially welcome our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Franklin S. Daniel, MA, MPhil, PhD. He is a very dedicated educationist. He has been working in Madras Christian College, Chennai, as an associate professor for more than 32 years. He is well known for his exceptional knowledge in grammar and literature. He assists in the development of English curriculum for the college. He has conducted quite a number of workshops, seminars, and conferences in various colleges. He has done innumerable international assignments to the universities of Malaysia, Hong Kong, Philippines, and the USA. There is no doubt that he will be a great inspiration for many of us. I kindly request our respected correspondent, sir, to felicitate the chief guest by presenting a memento and shawl. Keep cheering. Give him a big round of applause. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. So now the group of English teachers from Matriculation School. So next, I would like to welcome our beloved correspondent, Tyagarajan Marcus, sir, who enlightens the society with his service to God and service to the school. So happy to welcome our dynamic administrator, Mrs. Diana Peter Whiting, who is very encouraging and supportive. I wholeheartedly welcome our principal, Mrs. Karnoff, who constantly supports the students and staff. I extend my welcome to the staff of Ebenezer Marcus, who are very cooperative. Last but not the least, my dear students, the makers of the brighter world, I welcome you all, the inauguration of English Club. Welcome once again.
Thank you, Sanjeev sir, for inspiring words. It is always a pleasure to hear your thoughts. Our next event is the welcome dance, performed by our high school girls. Please welcome them to the stage.
If you believe you can move the highest mountains, cross the greatest oceans, and walk across the water, the world. Feel defeated, falling on your knees and looking up for some hope tonight. You try to stand up, but you throw your hands up, like you no longer have the strength to fight. 'Cause you've seen too many sunsets, too many days ending in the darkest night. But on your own, you'll never know, you'll never know. If you believe you can move the highest mountains, cross the greatest oceans, walk across the water, the world. All you need is faith, but it's almost like you lost your way. Took a few wrong turns, took a few breaks, falling behind now looking for grace. 'Cause you need someone to lift you up, yeah, make right all the things you've done. 'Cause on your own you'll never know, you'll never know. If you believe you can move the highest mountains, cross the greatest oceans, walk across the water, the world.
Across praise goes up. Your rain comes down. Oh, our praise goes up. Your rain comes down. Our praise goes up. Your rain comes down.
Thank you, girls, for your amazing performance. And that was electrifying.
Thank you, girls. English is not a subject. It's a language to communicate. Here we have Shruti of LKG to narrate a capsule story.
And the monkeys. Capsule was going to the village to sell his cap in the market. He was carrying a basket full of caps. When he crossing the forest, he got tired and slept under the tree. There was many monkeys on the tree. Capsule woke up. After some time, he looked up and saw the monkeys wearing his caps. Suddenly, the capsule got an idea. He took off his cap and threw it on the ground. Monkeys, the same as they are imitators. The capsule collect all caps, went away happily. Oh, love the story. Intelligence works wonders.
Thank you, Shruti, for the wonderful narration of Capsule Story. Next up, we have a very special presentation from our UKG kids. They will be performing an alphabet reverse order and phonetics presentation. Please welcome the UKG kids to the stage.
Good morning to all. I am Helen from UKG. I am going to tell alphabets in reverse order. Z, Y, X, W, V, U, T, S, R, Q, P, O, N, M, L, K, J, I, H, G, F, E, E, D, C, B, A.
Thank you.
Good morning to everyone. I am Anushka. I am studying UKG D section.
I am Akifa. I am studying in UKG D section.
We are going to tell the alphabet sounds. What is the sound of letter A? Sound of letter E?
Yeah.
Sound of letter I?
E.
Sound of letter X? Sound of letter G?
G.
Sound of letter B?
V.
Sound of letter S? Sound of letter N?
Z.
Sound of letter P?
P.
Sound of letter M?
M. Thank you.
Without taking much of your time, permit us to start the program. Ansi, do you feel any turbulence around here?
Yes, I do. The heartbeats have gone up and everyone is eager into sync to the depth of music, song, lights and joy. Well, here are classes 1 and 1 to 3 coming to perform an action song, Magical Words.
Hi everybody, this is Shivansh of 2nd B from Ebenezer Garden. Friends, can you guess some magical words? Yes, you are right. Please, sorry, thank you, excuse me and welcome. Here are my classmates to sing a song about the magical words. Here they go.
If you want something, what will you say?
I will say please, that's what I say.
If you hurt someone, what will you say?
I will say sorry. That's what I say.
If you are sneezing, what will you say?
I will say excuse me. That's what I say.
If you get something, what will you say?
I will say thank you. That's what I say.
If someone says thank you, what will you say?
I will say welcome. That's what I say. Hope you all would have learned about the magical words. These magical words can bring in peace with all. The five-letter word P-E-A-C can delete the five-letter word F-I-G-H-T, fight. So please practice these magical words in your day-to-day life. Thank you.
Thank you, classes of 1 to 3, for sharing us the importance of magical words by your cute little voices. Thank you. Here comes the performance of the students of higher secondary that portrays us the seven stages of life.
All the world is a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts. His acts make seven ages.
We didn't sleep too late.
At first, the infant.
There was a fire in the yard.
Mewling and puking
all
in the nurse's
the
arms.
Trees were in light. They had
then
no
the whining schoolboy. Satchel and shining morning face.
Seven swans,
creeping.
I heard a voice
like a snake.
I'll try.
Unwillingly to school.
I'll try.
And then the lover. Sighing like a furnace, with a baffled ballad, made to his mistress. Eyebrow. Then a soldier.
We saw the dragon move down.
Full of strange oaths.
My father burned into coal.
And bearded like a pot.
My mother
Jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel.
She took her purse to the bed,
seeking the bubble reputation.
I saw a sign in the sky,
even in the cannon's mouth.
Seven horns.
Then the justice.
I heard a voice in my mind.
In fear, round belly, the good capon lined. With eyes severe and beard a formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. And so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big manly voice turning again toward Charlie's treble pipes and whistles in his sound.
He will take you.
Last in a fall that ends this strange, eventful history is certain childishness and mere oblivion. Sun's teeth, sun's eyes, sun's taste, sun's everything.
Performance. It was a reminder to us about the different stages of life that we all go through. Next, here are students of class 3 to 5 on the stage to talk about the importance of global language.
Good morning to one and all present here. There are many languages spoken by people worldwide. Do you know which language is spoken widely in our world? Of course, it's English. Why do you think English is so important? Because English is a language used for global communication. The ability to communicate effectively in English enables one to connect with and participate actively in the international community as a global citizen. Now, let's see the value and importance of English communication skill through a skit.
Hey, Alashia, how are you? It's long since I saw you.
Hey, Bhairav, I'm fine. How about you? Are you free now? I'm going to meet Pranita and Dakshini in the restaurant. Would you like to join us?
Yes, of course, I'm free now and would gladly like to join you all.
Yes, come on, let's surprise them.
Hi, Bhairav. What a surprise. It's been a year, Bhairav. Where were you for so long? It looks like you are well placed in life. Got a good job?
Hey, wait, wait. First, let's settle down. What would you like to order?
Let's have fresh fruit juice. Waiter, please get us 4 apple juice.
What are you doing now?
I am a HR in ABC company.
Wow, great Bhairav. You are lucky. How did you achieve in such a short period? Though you are not so good in academics.
Can
you share your secrets with us?
Nothing special. It's all because of communication skills. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I have strong technical knowledge, but not so good in English. And also, I strongly feel it is not important to learn as it is foreign language. I love my India. I think you shouldn't say like that. We too love our country, India. But communication in English is the need of the hour.
Yes, and not only that. It is a universal language, the language of internet, and also it helps us in trade.
Very much true. It is also one of the widely spoken languages in the world and is taught in 118 countries.
Hey guys, it is also the language of science, aviation, computers, diplomacy and tourism.
Hi. So nice to see you all here. You did invite me. This shows that I am an uninvited guest. You all have forgotten me.
Hey, Stephen, actually, it is an unexpected meeting.
Waiter, one more juice, please.
Yeah, actually, I saw Alashia in the street tent and met Pranita and Dakshini in the restaurant.
What were you all discussing seriously?
We were talking about the importance of English and its communication skill.
Oh, so you mean that English is better than all the languages? India has more than 1,500 languages and I'm proud of it. English stands nothing in front of it. I love my mother tongue and my country.
Stop, Mr. Bharat. We too love our mother tongue and our country. Now that's not the matter here.
Yes, we were discussing that English is the most important communication skills around the world.
Hey, what we communicating here? Do you think that without English we can't survive?
Yes, of course, Stephen. If we want to be placed in high position in a job, we need good English.
Also, as English has the ability to connect people from all corners of the world, it has become the global language.
It also breaks the language barrier between different countries and gives access to meet new people, communicate with them and understand their cultures and heritages.
So, what about our languages?
We do respect our country and languages.
But we do need, and it has become our necessity to learn English to scale high in our career.
Yeah, I do agree with you all with this point. So, we have to know English to grow technically.
Okay. I do agree that it boosts our self-confidence. We should all work hard in developing the skill in English language.
Hey, we had a wonderful time together after a long gap. Let's meet often and help each other to boost our career and life.
Yeah, that's true. Let's all meet often and boost ourselves.
Bye.
My dear friends, through this skit, we understood that English communication skill plays a vital role in developing our life to a better life. So friends, shall we all focus on developing our English communication skill? Of course, yes, we should do that. Thank you all and have a nice day.
Thank you, classes 3 to 5, for your informative presentation. It is clear that you have a deep understanding of the importance of global language in today's world. I am confident that you will all go on to be a successful global citizen. Our next event is a fusion song titled Joy and Peace, performed by the middle school. Please welcome them to the stage.
By sharing us the wonder of joy and peace by your angelic performance.
Hello everyone. I am Abdiel, the SPL of this school. We, the students of higher secondary, are here to enact a skit on Oppenheimer, the father of atomic bomb. Are you all ready to travel into the adventure of the early 90s that completely changed the course of history forever? Let me introduce you all the characters. Shreyas as Dr. J. Robert Oppenheimer, the head and the chairperson of the Manhattan Project. He was hailed as the father of atomic bomb, but he hailed himself as the destroyer of the worlds. Balakarthikeyan as Albert Einstein. The man who gave us the vision of future and the greatest scientist of all time. Jaydev as Roosevelt. The president of the US government in the early 90s. Kishore as Gruce. The general and the director of the Manhattan Project. And Akshay as Louis Strauss. The chairman of US Atomic Energy Commission and the most cruel officer of his century. Then, what are we waiting for? Let's move into the visual journey of the atomic age.
Everyone, listen up. I have some urgent news. The Germans have split the atom of uranium. It's crucial. We must act swiftly to prevent them from developing a powerful atomic weapon.
That's deeply troubling. We must accelerate our own research to ensure we develop the bomb first.
Absolutely. This discovery changes everything. We need to assemble the best minds and resources to create a successful nuclear weapon.
I agree. Oppenheimer, you will be in charge of the Manhattan Project. We have to keep it top secret and focus all efforts on developing this weapon.
The atomic bomb will somehow be developed. We can't stop it, but we should create it before it gets into the hands of the Nazis. I'm feared of Heisenberg and his intelligence in quantum physics.
Time jumps ahead to 1942.
The research is progressing, but we need more resources and scientists to rage up our invention.
I fear the destructive potential of this bomb. It could change the course of history forever.
We must proceed with caution, but we can't let the Germans get ahead. We have a responsibility to protect our country. But anyways, we can't enjoy the beauty of this world again.
Finally, the bomb has been invented with the help of 4,000 scientists and $2 billion.
We did it. It's time to test its power. The name is the Trinity Test.
I never imagined my work on E is equal to mc square would lead to such a deadly thing.
Yes, it's successful. The bomb worked, and the energy released by it was beyond our imaginations and calculations.
My fears have come true. We must use this power wisely and responsibly.
The American government wanted to show their power to the entire world. Fortunately, a problem arose between US and Japan, and on August 6, 1945,
the Americans have dropped the bomb at Hiroshima. The radiation is causing a leap for them, so that they can never stand on their own for several generations.
That's a good news. So, we are the strongest nation in the world.
Are you out of your mind, Strauss? We made this bomb only to ensure security for our people. Are you kidding now? The next day, at the White House, with the President Roosevelt.
Well done, Robert. We made it. Now we become the strongest nation in the world.
It's fine. But why? Why did you drop the bomb and misuse the power? I felt deadly hearing this. I have become the cause of the death of millions of lives. I feel that I have the blood on my hands.
But Oppie, do you think they care about who built the bomb? They only talk about who dropped it.
Time jumps ahead to August 9th, 1945.
Oh my God, they are going beyond their level.
The world will never be the same.
Albert, bomb is meant for destruction and never to build a world out of it. Let them die.
Few people laughed. Few people cried. Most people were silent. Now, I am become death, destroyer of fools.
The American government built the bomb to ensure social security to the nation. But the government themselves misused the power they had, and at the end, the scientists were filled with regret and depression. Now, in the modern technology, we have the artificial intelligence as a powerful weapon in our hand. But it is up to us whether we make use of the technology and misuse it and regret about it later. Like the famous quote, with great power comes great responsibility. We have the AI as a great power in our hand, and it is our responsibility to make use of it effectively and efficiently. Dr. J. Robert Oppenheimer was awarded the father of atomic bomb, but after the deaths of millions of people, he spent the rest of his life only with depression and sadness. Special thanks to Joel Jabakuma and Calvin for the background score.
Thank you, higher secondary friends, for your powerful and thought-provoking performance.
To be honest, responsible and passionate, we need to learn some moral values in life. So to make this program more special, let's invite the students of class 1 and 2 to present a moral story.
My name is Enoch Daniel. I am studying second standard C section. Here comes a story of a great elephant. One day, an elephant wanted to make new friends in the jungle. He saw a monkey on a tree. The elephant said, "Will you be my friend?" Monkey said, "You are too big. You can't swing from tree like me." And next day, he met the rabbi. "Hey, dear rabbi, will you be my friend?" Rabbi said, "You are too big. You can't play in my burrow." And the elephant was so upset. Next day, he met the frog. "Hey, Mr. Frog, will you be my friend?" Frog said, "How is it possible? You are too big. How can I?" The elephant was so upset. And next day, all the animals running for their life. The elephant asked the monkey, "What happened, monkey? What happened? What is the matter?" Monkey said, "Lion is coming. Lion is trying to kill all of us." And the elephant went to the lion. "Hey, Mr. Lion, don't eat all the poor animals." Lion said, "Mind your own business, man." And the elephant gave the lion a hefty kick, and lion ran away. And all animals ran to him and said, "You are just the right size to be our friend." Moral of a story, a friend in need. Thank you all.
Thank you, young talents from classes 1 and 2, for your delightful performance.
Thank you. Someone just knocked. Sherlock, who could that be?
I think we can find out if you can open the door, John.
Mr. Holmes!
Okay, calm down. Take a seat. Tell us what happened.
There's no sweat on her face, so she wasn't running. She seems stressed. And look at the clouds and her wet skirt. She came from a distant place, possibly the next town.
Wait, wet skirt and clouds?
Yes, John. Look at the window. The clouds. It's been raining somewhere in London.
Wait, Sherlock? You're telling me she ran from there?
What is like inside your small head, John? She took a cab while it was raining and now she's here. She's well-dressed for a normal day. For a party? No. People don't dress classic for parties. You're from the Royal Opera House in Covent Garden. And John, it's actually raining in Covent Garden. I read it from the newspaper and that explains her wet skirt. And I think you're missing your diamond necklace.
Yes, but how do you know about the necklace?
Well, you went through all the process to flaunt yourself. Going to an opera without a necklace? Not possible. You did go there and you missed it somewhere.
Brilliant!
It is elementary, John. When did you last see the necklace?
I wore it to the opera and when I returned home, it was gone.
Do you know who might have taken it or you might have dropped it somewhere, right? That's possible.
I just got the necklace. So dropping it is not possible. Although there was the suspicious looking man sitting behind me at the opera.
Did you notice any features that may help us identify this man?
No. It was a bit dark in the daytime.
And you managed to find this man suspicious. How lovely of you.
Sorry about that. I think what Sherlock here means to say is that we'll look into your case. By the way, which seat are you sitting in?
John, look at this. There's paint smudge on this ticket.
Oh yeah, Sherlock. But what does it mean?
I remember dropping my ticket and I bent down to pick it up. That guy picked it up and gave it to me. It was dark, so I couldn't see his face or anything. Again, it was dark.
He must have seen this necklace when she bent down to get her ticket. Well, that explains the paint smudge.
The faceless phantom. Sounds good, right?
We're leaving now. John, get the ticket. We won't be back until later, Mrs. Hudson.
New case, Sherlock?
The game, Mrs. Hudson, is on.
You're Sherlock Holmes. And John Watson, you're in my tattoo shop. How can I help you, gentlemen?
We are looking for a man who may have visited your studio recently.
Possibly with a paint smudge on his clothes.
Oh, the paint on the clothes one. Yeah, that will be Mr. Tilden. He's one of our best artists. It's very hard to find him without his paint stuff. Oh yeah, he just got here an hour ago.
How did you find me?
There's paint on this lady's ticket. Who other than a tattoo artist would bring a paint to a theater? It's child's play, John. These cases are getting so easy. I think we should move out of London.
How did he steal her necklace, though?
Well, I've never seen someone dressed with looking like an opera geek sheep as she did. With her sleeping, it was easy to tug it off so. I needed money, and I thought I could sell the necklace to pay off my debts.
Pay off your prison debt and then find a way to pay your debt.
Mr. Holmes, you are truly remarkable.
Another case solved, Sherlock.
Indeed, John, the game is always afoot.
High secondary students for the another amazing performance.
Your detective play was full of suspense. And you kept us guessing until the very end. Our next event is a skit titled Peace, performed by the middle school. Please welcome them to the stage.
No one is happy in my family. My brother again started to fight with my parents. My brother wants new bike, so he is fighting with my parents.
Why do you need a new bike? Can't you manage with your old bike? You only know how to waste money. You don't even know how to save it.
My dear son, you know very well, our financial condition is not good. We are struggling to make both our ends meet. So you please manage with your old bike.
Ah, please stop it. Enough. My head will burst. This old bike stops again and again. I can't ride it. You ride it yourself. I badly need a new bike, so please make arrangement for it. That's it.
This is all your fault. You were the one who made him worse by pampering him.
Oh God, please show some way to make everyone happy and bring peace in my family.
Mom, Mom, Dad, bro, look here.
What happened, my dear? Why are you shouting?
Look outside.
Oh, it is raining hard. Who are you all? Why are you getting wet? Please come in, come in.
Thank you very much for inviting us inside. But we have a rule.
Rule? What rule?
Only one of us can come inside. Whom would you like to invite in?
Oh, I see. But who are you all?
I am Peace. My job is to spread peace and harmony all over the world.
I am Success. Because of me only, there are many successful people in the world who make their parents proud of them.
I'm Prosperity. Everyone is happy because of me. There is happiness all around because of me. If there is happiness, then everything is there.
I am Wealth. You can get everything you desire. You cannot survive without me in today's world.
You call me inside.
No, no, no. Call me inside.
No, no. Call me inside.
No, call me inside to end all your problems.
I think we should call Wealth inside. Only then can we live a happy life.
No, no, no. We should call Success so that I can be successful in my life and make you all proud of me.
Wait, wait. I think we must invite Prosperity. Then there will be happiness and prosperity in our life.
No, we must invite Wealth.
No, no, no. We should call Success.
No, no, no. Prosperity.
Listen, listen. Why should we not invite Peace? I think we should call Peace in our home. Then there will be happiness.
Yes, my child, you are right. We should invite Peace inside.
Peace, please come in. Wait, you said that any one of you only can come inside. And when we invited Peace, you all are coming inside.
Yes, we have another rule that where there is peace, there is success, prosperity and wealth follow automatically.
Oh, we welcome all four of you. Please come in.
Yes, yes, come in.
Now I understand how much peace is needed to make everyone happy. Since we invited Peace, we are having everything now. So, Mom, Dad, Bro, let us pray that peace and harmony prevail all over the world. The inner peace is the foundation for the happy and successful life.
Okay, my dear, sure we'll pray to God that everyone must embrace peace to lead a happy life.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. That was awesome. Thank you, guys, for conveying us the wonders of peace by a beautiful and energetic skit. Now let us welcome the higher secondary team who are here for narrating the poem Lines Written in Early Spring.
I heard a thousand blended notes while in a groove I sat reclined. In that sweet mood when pleasant thoughts bring sad thoughts to the mind. To her fair works did nature link the human soul that through me ran, and much it grieved my heart to think what man has made of man. Through primrose tufts in the sweet bower, the periwinkle trail it reads, and it's my fate that every flower enjoys the air it breathes. The birds around me hopped and played, their thoughts I cannot measure, but the least motion which they made, it seemed a thrill of pleasure. The budding twigs spread out their fan to catch the breezy air, and I must think, do all I can, that there was pleasure there. If this belief from heaven be sent, if such be nature's holy plan, have I not reason to lament? Have I not reason to lament? What man has made of man? What man has made of man?
Please stop. Listen to me. We are created not to fight with each other, not to destroy the natural resources that God has given. We people neither have unity nor live in harmony with each other. The Creator thinks like flowers, birds, plants, enjoy nature. But we, the human beings, neither have unity, but we should live with harmony with each other, share love among each other, and experience peace among ourselves. So come on, friends. Let's live in unity.
Students, for your beautiful recitation of William Wordsworth's poem.
Your performance was truly moving and you capture the beauty of Hope of Spring perfectly. Next, stay tuned for an enthralling performance of The Merchant of Venice court scene by our high secondary students.
Morning everyone. As you all know about the play Merchant of Venice, which was written by William Shakespeare, it portrays the story of Antonio, who fails to reimburse the money he had borrowed from the Jewish moneylender, Shylock. And as part of the bond signed by Antonio with Shylock, Antonio is obliged to give Shylock a pound of his flesh. A humane and ingenious intervention by lawyer saves Antonio.
The Duke has arrived.
Is Antonio here?
Yes, sir. I'm here.
I feel sorry for you. You have come to face a ruthless enemy, an inhuman wretch, incapable of pity, who is without any feelings of mercy at all.
They tell me you have done everything you can to talk to him out of what he's doing, but he remains stubborn, and there's no legal way to protect me from this malice. I'm ready to suffer peacefully in whatever he does to me in his cruelty and anger.
One of you, go and call the Jew into the court here.
He is standing ready outside the door. Here he comes, my lord.
Shylock, everyone thinks, and I agree, that you are pretending to be cruel. They think that at last moment you'll show mercy and pity, which will be more surprising than the bizarre cruelty you seem to be showing now. What do you say? We all expect a nice answer from you, Jew.
I have possessed your grace of what I purpose, and by our holy Sabbath have I sworn to have the forfeit of my bond. And if you deny it, let the danger light upon your city's freedom. Are you answered?
That's no answer, you artless man. It does not excuse your cruel behavior.
I don't have to give answers that you like.
Please, don't bother arguing with the Jew. You might as well go stand on the beach and ask the ocean to get smaller. Just let the Jew take his penalty.
Instead of your 3,000 ducats, here are 6,000 ducats.
If you offer 6 times more, I wouldn't accept it.
My lord, a messenger is waiting outside with letter from Dr. Bellario. He's just come from Padua.
Bring us the letter. Call the messenger in. Have you been sent by Dr. Bellario?
Yes, my lord. Bellario sends his greetings to you.
Why are you sharpening your knife so eagerly?
To cut my penalty from that bankrupt man over there.
I have received your letter, but I am very sick at that moment. As it happened, when your messenger came, a young lawyer from Rome was visiting me. His name is Balthasar. I told him about the case of Jew and Antonio the merchant, and we consulted many books together. He knows my legal opinion about this matter, and he has his own expert opinion as well.
The lawyer has arrived.
And you are the legal professor, I believe. Did Bellario send you here?
Yes, my lord.
Welcome. Are you familiar with this case currently?
Yes, thoroughly. Which one is the Jew and which one the merchant?
Antonio and Shylock, both of you come forward.
Is your name Shylock?
Shylock is my name.
Your case is the most unusual. Though the Venetian law can't stop you from proceeding, he has a claim on you, correct?
Yes, so he says.
And do you acknowledge the bond?
I do.
Can't he just pay you back the money?
Yes, I'm offering to pay it right even this moment, even twice the sum. I beg you, just this once, use your authority and bend the law.
This can't happen. The change will result in many bad legal decisions that can take place. Let me review the contract.
Here it is, Judge. Here it is.
Shylock, they're offering you 3 times the money you lent.
But I made an oath in heaven. Should I disobey? No, not for all of Venice.
The quality of mercy is not strained. It
blessed him that gives and him that takes. It's dread and fear of kings. It is an attribute of awe and majesty. But mercy is about the scepter's sway. It is an attribute from God Himself. Therefore, Jew, consider this, though justice be thy plea, show mercy to the merchants there. But if it does not follow, though, let the strict court of Venice give the sentence against the merchant there.
I will show no mercy, and I claim a pound of his flesh.
Very well. So bear your chest, Antonio. Is there a scale to weigh the pound of flesh?
Here it is.
Call a surgeon to bind his wounds so he doesn't bleed to death.
Is that mentioned in the bond?
Not explicitly, but so what? It doesn't hurt to be charitable. You, merchant, do you have anything to say?
Not much. Ready and waiting. Give me a hand, Bassanio. Goodbye.
A pound of this merchant's flesh. The law and the court of Venice allows it.
What a wise judge you are!
But wait a moment!
What?
There's something else. The bond clearly and specifically says a pound of flesh. So take your penalty. But if you shed even one drop of Christian blood, the land at the court of Venice will confiscate your property.
Is that the law? In that case, let me have my money back.
Well, only justice will be served. What mercy can you show him, Antonio?
Well, if the Duke and the court allows it, then let the court have one half of his property and the other half let his son and daughter-in-law possess.
Are you satisfied? What do you say, Jew?
I'm satisfied.
Well, sign the document to make the decision official. We come to realize that sweet mercy is better than strict justice. Portia, disguised as a lawyer, brings peace to Antonio's disturbed heart. The love of Bassanio captures one's ideal thoughts on true friendship. Mercy and compassion is above all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, higher secondary students, for your outstanding performance of this iconic scene from The Merchant of Venice. Your acting was superb, and you brought the characters to life with your passion and skill.
May I now request our chief guest, Dr. Franklin S. Daniel, to come forward. Amongst your claps, please, give a big round of applause. Is Dr. Franklin Daniel, we are greatly honored and humbled, sir, to have your presence. And may I now, for being excellent in English, give Shruti a big round of applause. Then comes Ellen Sophia of UKGB. And here comes Sadhana Ilango of First Standard C-Section. Sandana Ilangu of First Standard C. And Enoch Daniel V of Second C is receiving his prize for being excellent in the language of English. Then Bhairav Krishna of 5A. And Alaya Shyakaran D of 5E. And Arshana I of 8th Standard B Section. Only few prizes, so you can be loud enough to clap and encourage these students. And Regilin Sindri I am of 8C. Shivani BP of 9F. And Tejashwini SK of 10E. And Sharon Rebecca of 11D. Was playing the role of Portia from the play The Merchant of Venice, Sharon Rebecca. And here comes Rania T. Hem of 12C. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. And I'm extremely happy to be in your midst this morning. I'm greatly honored to be here at the inaugural of your literary club. And I was witnessing the wonderful performance of you, the dear students. And let me tell you, let me congratulate you. The music, the dance, the singing, your acting, your reciting, and the way you expressed yourself was just fantastic. So let me congratulate, and I would like to give you a big round of applause. Would you just clap for yourself? I'm not going to take much of your time. Let me, at the outset, thank the beloved correspondent, the administrator, Mrs. Diana, and Principal Ma'am, and the wonderful set of teachers that you have in this school to groom all of you. And you, kids, I'm so glad that you're all here. I know it is extremely hot and you have been through this heat for quite a while. So I'm not going to really stretch it. But let me tell you, you see the structures here, the buildings here, and they represent something that you can learn in life. It's not magical that it appeared. It was built brick by brick. And so, my dear friends, in life, you have to take one step at a time. And while you're in school, you have to put your best foot forward. You should come forward to take part in the activities of the literary club. You know, like I was very impressed because you chose something that is close to my heart, the alphabet in the reverse order, and you know, the magical words, the action song, and so on and so forth. Let me tell you, you have a brilliant set of teachers who encourage you. You know, though the workload for them is very heavy, in spite of that, they groom you. What you achieve at a later point in time, you will see in hindsight that it was all the efforts that was put in by school teachers. My memory goes back some 50 years. When I see you children, I'm so thrilled. When I see the brilliant, bright faces in front of me, that gives me a shot in the arm. It encourages me. And it was all the first step that I took. I did not know that I'll come this far. But, you know, you strive for excellence. That is a motto that everyone should have. An operative motto in your life. Everyone should strive for what? You should strive for? Listen, no one listened to what I was speaking. You should strive for? I said one word. What is that word? Excellence. Excellence. You should strive for? Can I hear you? Do I have an audience in front of me? You should strive for? Can we have one more time, dear friends? You should strive for? That is brilliant. You're all awake. I thought you all slept off in the hot sun. Right? Please don't faint. And I was so happy when I saw the band that was performing as I was walking by. Good. So very often, you know, we train our minds. We are in a good school. Ebenezer, Marcus, Matriculation, Higher Secondary School. and you have been inculcated with the best of values. Dear friends, this is what is going to carry a long way in life, right? There is no shortcut. Just imagine in a class, if someone, you know, tries to copy or copies, that person may get good marks, but that won't last for long, because we live in times wherein we are being watched. Everyone is being watched. There is the closed circuit TV camera. You know, at the signal, at the junction, you have cameras. If you do not wear a helmet, you'll be fined. And the notification will come on your mobile phone. Right? So, dear friends, there's no shortcut in life. You need to work hard. You need to put in extra effort, because we live at a time wherein the competition is very, very severe. But don't lose heart. Don't lose heart, as we saw in one of the skits, or what was it, the friend's restaurant, right? It was not the person who got the first mark who made it big in life. So it is all the effort. You know, sometimes in English we call that serendipity, but it's also the grace of God that is there, which will help you a great deal in life. Never, never despair. Don't lose heart. Right? Don't throw in the towel, as they would say in boxing. If you throw in the towel, if the coach throws in the towel, it means the boxing bout has come to an end, because his man is getting a severe beating. He'll be knocked out. But never throw in the towel, right? So I was so glad that, you know, there were some of the letters of the English alphabet that were made use of in your program, right? So it is not alphabets, it is the English alphabet, singular, right? It represents the 26 characters or the 26 letters of the English alphabet. And I was dismayed when a kid came forward and said, Jed! It's Zed, right? So these are certain things that you have to focus on. I hope you have a language lab in school wherein you would be given an opportunity to listen to some of the intonation, the stress aspect, and so on. English is a stress time language. Okay, so I'm not going into greater details, but take for example the letter W, or for that matter A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. You know, these are certain things that you would learn when you listen to it carefully, right? So there is the mother tongue influence. Don't be carried away by that. You should all get yourself a good English pronouncing dictionary called the Daniel Jones English Pronouncing Dictionary. It's available in Amazon. And there it will tell you as to how you should stress and how you should articulate a given word, right? So it is H. And for example, the word, the letter W, as I told you, how many phonemes does it have? You know, is there anyone who would tell me what a phoneme is? A high secondary student will be able to tell me what is a phoneme. A phoneme is a minimal sound unit. In the word W, you have 6 phonemes. How many phonemes? One letter, it has how many phonemes? 6 phonemes. Maybe you have to research and find out as to what those different phonemes are. And the person who manages to speak well, to articulate well, will go a great distance in life, right? So since the theme was on peace, I was thinking of, you know, something that would be of some significance, right? And you had the portrait of Shakespeare in front of you, the greatest dramatist, wherein one of those soliloquies was enacted, the 7 stages of man, and the court scene of the Merchant of Venice. So, dear friends, let me tell you that English is a stress time language, and the word peace, I was thinking of some code that would fit into this kind of a theme this morning, and I was reminded of Rabindranath Tagore's Gitanjali. When he says the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. The world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. We live at times wherein the world is divided. The world is divided, terribly divided. We have a war that is happening in Ukraine. Russia has invaded Ukraine. It wants to annex Ukraine. That was how the First World War began. How did it begin? When Austria was invaded. So I'm just cautioning you, you know, it looks as though everything is fine, but everything is not fine. There is going to be a collapse in economy. And right now, in the Middle East, there is a big war that's happening. A hospital has been demolished. We do not know whether it was an Israeli bomb or a Palestinian bomb, because the Israelite, they have what is called as an iron dome. So whenever the Palestinians launch a rocket, a missile, it will be redirected. It will just fall on their own heads. So dear friends, so there is this kind of thing that is happening where the world has been broken into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Look at the foresight of the great Guruji Rabindranath Tagore, right? And into that haven of freedom, he says, my father, let my country awake. So right now, we are going through that process wherein we need to have that peace, that harmony. How would that exist? How is it possible to have that peace, that harmony, right? Only if you have kindness towards another person. Kindness. You should be kind to another person, right? There are so many things that people boast of. Maybe they boast of their wealth. Maybe they boast of their education. They'll be proud about so many things. But if you are proud, you are not going to be one of those perpetrators of peace, but you're going to be a perpetrator of violence. So in this kind of an atmosphere, this is what you have to imbibe. You have to get more of that kindness. I just want to close this small address with a story, right? The story is called The Peaceful Meadow. The peaceful what? The peaceful meadow, M-E-A-D-O-W. What is a meadow? It's a grassland. It is a what? A place that is full of grass, a grassy surface. So it happened long, long ago. Maybe the children may love stories. It's for the children. Long, long ago, there was this place called, in a faraway land, called the peaceful meadow. And the animals that were there, they were very happy. They were peaceful. There was happy coexistence. And what happened was, suddenly, there was this Roger Rabbit, who was very, very inquisitive. The rabbit wanted to find out as to how this place is so peaceful, where in other places they just rip apart each other. And this rabbit went and stood before a big tree, which is an oak tree. And on that oak tree, there was this wise owl called Oliver. What is the name of the owl? Oliver. Okay, asked the owl as to how this place is so peaceful. And the owl just rolled its eyes and said, many, many years ago, there was this fight that was happening. And there was this squirrel that wanted to spread peace. And the motto that the squirrel spread was that we should help one another, that we should live in harmony. So from that time onwards, animals were happy. They were kind of helping the other animal to build its place of rest. And when there was a storm, it just helped the animals to find a shelter. So that was how it kind of progressed, and that place became a peaceful meadow. So this morning, What I want to leave with you children and young adults, right? You're in junior college. When you're in higher secondary, it's almost like you're one step into the college. What you want to propagate is that kindness, right? Since the theme was on peace, what you have to perpetrate is kindness, not violence. Tolerance is the word, right? We need to be tolerant. And it's not going to be a very, very, easy path. But let me tell you, friends, but God's grace is there, right? You have a beautiful atmosphere. Your parents, with great sacrifice, have put you in the school. To have a good education is not all that easy. They have to sacrifice a lot. And they have sacrificed a lot. So let me wish you the very best. And take part in such programs which will catapult you to greater heights, right? So whatever altitude is going to be determined is the base that you build, right? So this is the base that you have. And on this base, solid structure could be built. That is your life, right? The life that has to be built on the rock. So I would like to reiterate that motto that I gave you. Strive for what? Strive for? That's good. Strive for? Thank you so much for this opportunity and God bless.
And the staff members, I thank our guests this morning. Accepted our invitation and in spite of his busy schedule. Thank you so much, sir, for accepting our invitation and inspiring us with wonderful message. Thank you so much. And I thank all the teachers, especially the English department teachers, for all your wonderful program. So really, you have enjoyed, no, children? Have you enjoyed? That's good. Okay, now, I thank all the students. So though it's very hot, you are so patient. So thank you so much, children. Okay, I don't want to take much of your time. So once again, I thank all of you so for maintaining this quietness. Thank you.
As William Arthurward, a motivational speaker, writer, once said, feeling gratitude and not expressing, it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. So honorable chief guest, respected correspondents, senior principal, administrators, principal headmistress of all the sections and students, I deem it a great honor and privilege to be the one making the closing remark and extending the vote of thanks on this remarkable occasion. First and foremost, I extend my huge thanks to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success with His mercy and blessing. Deep from my heart and from our heart, we extend a huge thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Franklin S. Daniel, not only for his valuable time and presence, also for his inspirational words and his experience shared. You know, my children, when I first asked him whether he could be our chief guest, without any doubt, he said he consented to be our chief guest. Can you put a big round of applause for our chief guest? I asked him, sir, can you send me your profile? He asked me for a mail ID. I sent my mail ID. I just wanted to go through the profile. It was 12 pages. How many pages? 12 pages. I was just wondering and amazed at the achievements and at the levels of learning. And he has been an editor for so many national publishing books. And he is a solo pianist. And he has completed the bass vocal course he has taken it in the Trinity College of London. And so many other things which I cannot tell it now. So thank you so much, sir, for having consented to be here in our midst. Thank you, sir. I mention my deep sense of gratitude to our correspondent and our senior principal and our principal and HMs of all the blocks, because whenever we go for any program, they say, sir, there's no program. That's not the word that they say. They said, how many programs you want? This is what they say. So can you all give a big round of applause for such teachers and such HMs and a leading captain or principal? Thank you so much for all your efforts. And we are extremely sorry for today. It's very hot, son. And at last, our students enthusiastically participated. And remarkable performance. Do you agree with me? Do you agree with me? Yes or no? Thank you so much for all the participants. And thank you for all the teachers who are behind them. So thank you so much. And also people here with the camera. And my brother Sam and brother Appu and all the other people who made this event a grand success. Thank you and thank you once again.
I request all the students to stand up for the national anthem.
Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind, Bharat Bhagya Vidhata, Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha, Dravida Utkala Vanga, Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga, Uchala Jaladhi Taranga. तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।